Just in, Rand Paul's wife issues shock statement, this is huge. Despite what the mainstream media says, Kentucky Senator Rand Paul was not a terrible neighbor, nor did he in any way deserve the vicious assault he received from Renee Boucher. According to Paul's wife, hateful reporting has twisted the story so as to make her husband partially responsible for the attack. In an op-ed that Kelly Paul wrote for CNN, she took outlets like the Daily Mail and others to task for spreading lies about her seriously injured husband. It is incredibly hurtful that some news outlets have victimized Rand a second time as he struggles to recover, delighting in hateful headlines like "Not a Perfect Neighbor," and concocting theories about an ongoing dispute, based on nothing more than speculation from an attention-seeking person with no knowledge of anything to do with us, Paul wrote. Also, according to Mrs. Paul, the attacker had not communicated with Paul in over 10 years. The fact is, neither Rand nor I have spoken to the attacker in 10 years, since before his wife and children moved away, other than a casual wave from the car. Nobody in our family has, nor have we communicated with anyone in his family. With Rand's travel to DC in the last 7 years, he has rarely seen this man at all. Some conservative media outlets have described Paul's attacker, Renee Boucher, as a socialist who harbors hatred towards Paul's libertarian politics. Several of Paul's neighbors in Bowling Green, Kentucky have come forward to say that Boucher was known to her and his more conservative neighbors about health care and other liberal issues. Jeff Jones, a registered nurse who worked alongside Boucher at the Bowling Green Medical Center, has characterized Boucher's politics as liberal. The Facebook account maintained by Boucher prior to the attack showed a predilection for posting anti-Republican invectives. Given this circumstantial information, it would appear that Boucher's attack was politically motivated. Kelly Paul believes this as well, saying that the reasons for Boucher's assault were all in his mind. The only dispute existed solely in the attacker's troubled mind, until, on a beautiful autumn day, he ran down the hill on our property and slammed his body into Rand's lower back as he stood facing away, wearing noise-canceling headphones to protect his ears from the lawnmower, Mrs. Paul wrote. None of this has stopped some mainstream outlets from continuing to claim that Paul and Boucher had a boundary dispute. So far, Boucher has pleaded not guilty to assaulting Paul. Boucher's attack is the second serious assault that Paul has survived since former Bernie Sanders volunteer James T. Hodgkinson shot up a Republican softball practice in Alexandria, Virginia. It reveals how unhinged the American left has become. Boucher made sure that his attack happened while Paul was defenseless. Furthermore, despite initial reports that Boucher only caused minor injuries, Kelly Paul says that her husband's broken ribs, retained fluid, and struggles with pneumonia have made even the necessary act of breathing painful. Such assault will continue to target Republican lawmakers until the media finally owns up to the fact that they have played a major role in demonizing right-wing Americans as Nazis and other vile slurs.